स्टूडेंट, दिस इज प्रीति मोरे एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टूडेज यूट्यूब वीडियो. नाउ इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर फ्रॉम ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 11 आर एनवायरमेंट एंड वॉट वी हैव सीन इन दैट एनवायरमेंट वॉट टॉपिक वी हैव कवर्ड. वी हैव सीन द नेचुरल एनवायरमेंट दैट at the different places, different environment we can see and we can feel it. So according to the environment, people adjust their lifestyle, their food, their habit is different according to their place environment. Even we have seen the environment has two components, abiotic components and biotic components. So what comes in the abiotic components? That means abiotic components means non-living thing. And what comes in it? It comes land, water and air. These three topic is very important. This three concept is very important in abiotic components. That means a physical components, land, water and air. Now even we have covered the biotic components and what comes in the biotic components, all the living things like human being, animal and and plant. So there are the producers, two important categories are there. One producer, autotrophs, that means the living being that can make their own food, such as plant. Plant make their own food by using the water, sunlight and gases of carbon dioxide. So in the producer, in the autotrophs, what comes there? Plant. Now the consumer is there. So consumer is also called heterotrophs. Heterotrophs, that means the consumer, living beings that depend on the plant and animals their own food, such as human being and animals. In the consumers, there are human beings also come and the animals also come, because the animal and human being, they don't make their own food like plant. They depend on another, some animals are depend on plants and animals also, like lion, tiger, they eat another's animal flesh. And some animals like cow, goat, they depend on plants. And some human beings are also there who eat both flesh and plants also. So this thing we have completed in the last video. Now today we are going to see the interaction between the components of the environment. Interaction between the components of the environment, that means at the different places, different atmosphere and the environment is there. So what the relation is there between the components, between that peoples and their environment. So you also open the page number 113 and there is the interaction between the components of the environments. So I just read first and then will explain it. The interaction and the relation between all living organism among themselves as well as with their physical environment, that means the natural surrounding, form a complex system referred to as an ecosystem. Any unique or conspicuous area like a lake or a desert can form a distinct ecosystem by itself. The organism found in any of this ecosystem would happily survive provided the condition remain favorable. So what is there? So there is the interaction between components and of the environment. We know that different places has their different environment. In the previous video also I have explained, at the Kashmir, if you see the environment of the Himachal Pradesh and if you see the environment at the desert side at Rajasthan, so both places have their separate environment and the people has to survive themselves according to the environment. So we know that the different organism are my best in their own natural environment, because the people become used to with that environment and they eat food according to it. Their habits also change according to environment, their lifestyle, habit, food, everything just change according to the environments. So the nature has created each living creature in such a way that it develops based in their own environment. So they just used to with that natural environment. The people, if some people are from the Himachal Pradesh, so from Kashmir, their environment you can see it is very cold. And if you see the environment at the desert side, so their environment is very hot. So the people and the atmosphere, they are just adjust with each other, with the environment, and according to the environment they just behave and they just live their life, and that's way it develop the best in its own environment, and they become the best to survive in such kind of environment. Even the relation between all living organism as well as the relation of this organism with their physical environment form a complex system called an ecosystem. Now what that relation, that means the people, organism means the people, organism means their people, that the different places and its environment and their people. So the people of that particular place and the environment of that particular place, their both relation is as the relation of this organism with their physical environment, the people's relation with its environment form a complex system. That forms a complex system. That means the people's, if we just take the example of Rajasthan, the people's where live at the desert side, their people and the desert environment. That desert's environment, their environment and the people of that desert size, their relation between make a complex system. Make a complex system. That relation is calling as ecosystem. That relation is calling ecosystem. The people's relation with its environment is calling ecosystem. So as the climate condition, altitude, etc., grassland, desert, lake, delta or an mangrove swamp are the example of ecosystem. See, if you see at the sea area, at the sea area, people's and their its atmosphere and their lifestyle, their food, their dressing sense, it is very different if you see the people from the Kashmir and from the desert side. Their lifestyle, their food, their dressing sense, these are the different. We can see the difference between the different places and at the different areas. So here we have seen what is ecosystem. Ecosystem means a complex system between the environment and their people. The particular place of environment and the particular places of the people, the environment and the people, organism, between their relation is make a complex system, and that complex system is called ecosystem. So organism found in any of this ecosystem would happily survive provided the condition remain consistent and favorable. So they are just became used to survive that particular environment, and happily they spend their life at that environment. They don't nomad here and there, they don't roam from here to here. They just became used to survive in that environment, and happily they just live their life over there, and they just adjust with the climate condition, altitude, their desert and lake, they just become used to for this all the environment and they live their life very happily over there. So the interaction between the organism, the living organism and the environment make a complex system, and that complex system is called ecosystem. So here it was just written there. Now let's see the human environment. So let's see the human environment, what is there in the human environment. So the in human environment, what is there? Human environment includes all human creations and the activities. Human being have the continuously adapted to their physical environment and also affected it since the earliest time. In the past, human needs were basic and simple, and so human being did not disturb the environment much. Over a period of time, with increase in population, human needs also increased and people started to expand their area of influence. Forests were cleared to get land for agriculture, new towns were built, animals were killed for the food and other needs. All these activities have had an adverse effect on the environment. For example, many species of animal and birds have become extinct because of deforestation. Deforestation is also the reason for increase in the amount of carbon dioxide in the air, which is main cause of global warming. Now, what is there in the human environment? In the human environment, we have seen now. In the ancient period, people doesn't know anything. Everything was the challenge for them. They were just adjusting themselves with the environment, with the world. So they were not knowing, they were just blank. How to get the food, how to live, what to wear, how to make fire. That means the each and everything was very difficult and everything was just challenging for them. And even for the food, searching of food, they were just roam from one place to another place. That means their life was nomadic, but they didn't hurt the environment. They didn't hurt the environment and they didn't harm to environment. But as the population is growing, and that time in the ancient period the population was very less and people was also not knowing much more thing, no techniques and nothing. So they were not knowing how to use this environment. But now we can see the people becomes very technical and now they are using the lots of things from this environment. So the great change that has been brought about in the environment in the result of human influence. So in the olden time, with low population and simple living, the requirement and the demand of people were limited. In the ancient period, we can see the peoples have they don't need that much thing, just food, and for the living thing, the important needs, they need that. But now we can see the peoples are very demanding. As the population is increasing, people's demand is also increasing. And in the ancient period, the people's demand was very limited. So they didn't harm the environment. Therefore, the environment didn't get affected much. In the ancient period, the ancient people just enjoy living in the environment. They didn't hurt the environment, and even they didn't even the environment also didn't got affected from them. With the increase in the population, now the population is increasing day by day. The population is increasing. That's why the living for the places for the living and the food demand is increasing, because if the population is increasing, so the family need more house and more place to live. They need more food to eat. So what the people done? The demand surge out of the proper proportion and suddenly the environment condition change drastically all over the world. As the population is increased, the people demand is also increased. That's why what they did, so indirectly it is hurting, it is making harm to the environment, because for making house they need more space. So what they started cutting the trees, they cleared the jungle, they cleared the forest, and there they made society, there they made buildings. And for farming also, if the food demand is also increased, that's why the farming also increased. So for making the factory, for the occupation, they made many more factories and everything. They cleared the forest and they made their building, factories, companies. So here it is indirectly hurting the environment. It is indirectly hurting the environment, and the environment get affected by the increasing population. So the more land was needed to build new cities, housing, colonies, industries, roads, railways, school, because this all is happening just because of increasing of the population. Because if the population is increasing, so there is need of to build a school. If the people are increasing, so there is need to make new house, new buildings, roads, railway, hospitals. So the forests were cleared and the fertile agriculture farm were converted into the colonies. Now what they did, the people cleared the forest and what they made there, they made their school, buildings, factories, road, railway station, hospitals, many more things. Just because of the increasing of the population, this everything was happened, and they just cleared the forest, and in the place of the forest they made many more buildings and many more things. So here the human being is solely responsible for disturbing the ecosystem with the disastrous effect like fertile, infertile land, population, and that's why the population is also increased. Water population we can see, air population pollution we can see, water pollution we can see, and even water and land pollution is also there. So this is this all thing just affected to the environment. This all thing just affected to the environment. And the deforestation, because of the deforestation land become too hot. Because of the deforestation land become too hot, such action cause imbalance in the atmosphere, cause and increase the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. Because the man did for his own cause, he cleared the forest, he made the buildings, he made the roads, railway station. Because increasing of the population, all the demands was increased. Food demands, living demands, occupation demands, school education demands, hospital demand, this all demand was increased. So the man cleared the forest, and in the place of forest they made such new things over there. So the deforestation of this thing, the land become the land cleared and the land become too hot, and more the gas of the carbon dioxide created and it mix in the atmosphere, and imbalance in the atmosphere and cause increase of the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So that's why the deforestation, because of the deforestation land become too hot and the carbon dioxide level is increased and it mixed in the atmosphere. So this created a blanket effect and the traps of heat warms and the lower atmosphere, and it caused the global warming. Deforestation and the increasing the level of the carbon dioxide in the air, this all become global warming. This all become the global warming here. So So need of increased people started the expand their influence. Forest were cleared to get the land for the agriculture. We have seen for making the building, for making the school, hospital, railway station, schools. This area where even the animal were also killed. Animal were also killed for the food. Many we can see the non-vegetarian peoples are also here. So for getting the flesh, they kill the animal and they get the meat from them. So many they cut the plants, they kill the animal. This all things are affected to the environment. That's why the deforestation, the carbon dioxide level is increased in the air, and the global warming is increasing day by day. So what is the main cause of the global warming? Deforestation. So what we have to do, we just have to plant more tea. We should plant more tea to decrease the global warming. Here we have completed this chapter 11, our environment. In the environment, what we have seen, the natural environment, biotic or physical component, biotic components, and biotic component we have seen the producer, autotrophs, consumers, heterotrophs, and the interaction between the components and the environment, how the people, how the other organism exists with its environment, and they happily spend their life at that particular environment. Now the human environment also we have seen how the global warming increased, how the people demands increase. This all we have seen in this environment, in our environment. So here the end of the chapter, our environment. So you just note down this glossary is there. Glossary in autotrophs. What is autotrophs? Heterotrophs and the biosphere. So you just note down this all the main points of meaning of this particular word in your notebook. Now I hope student you got all the main points of this lesson, of the chapter, our environment. Now what is there, the exercise is there on page number 114. Fill in the blanks with appropriate words. So we just take this exercise orally. A, the environment comprises land, blank space and air. So land, water and air. What will come there in the first blank space? Water. Now the second is I hope you have written this, so I just rub it. So in the first blank, what comes there? There will come water. And now the second, the blank space layer protect us from harmful ultraviolet rays. Now the second one, ozone. Now the C, all living organisms are found in the biosphere. Now D are autotrophs. Who are autotrophs? Plants. D, deforestation is a threat to the environment. So the first answer is at the blank place water, B's answer is ozone, C answer is biosphere, D's answer is plant and E's answer is environment. Now the second is choose the correct answer. Abiotic components of the environment includes four options are there, plant, animal, both plant and animal, fourth air, water and land. Abiotic components, which three important parties there? Air, water and land. Option number D, tick the option D. Biotic component do not include option A, plant, B, bacteria, 3, water vapor and animal. So the option number 3 is correct, water vapor. Now C, a natural ecosystem does not include option A, forest, lake, mountain, school. So the option is school. Tick the school. Now D, one of these is not the heterotrophs, cacti, tiger, snake, elephant. So the correct answer is cacti. E, human environments includes option first, mountain, 2, river, 3, forest, 4, factories. So the fourth number, factory, is the correct option. Now let's see the true and false. The two components of the natural environment are plants and animal. Yes, this is true. B, abiotic components of the natural environment include land and water. Yes, this is also true. C, human beings are autotrophs. This is false. D, plants are heterotrophs. This is also false. E, human activities affect the environment. It is true. So here we have taken exercise first 2 and 4 and the question answer you will be provided soon. Now we have completed here the chapter 11, our environment. Now we'll meet soon in our next video. Till then, bye bye, take care and thank you.